Hey, I'm Ira from Yesayer. We're at Melt Festival 2012. I loved it. Yeah. No, I did. I mean, this is an unbelievable sight. It's a very abnormal. So many of the times that you play a festival, it's just like a cow pasture in the middle of the woods, you know, or polo grounds or something. But this is just a epic environment to be on, especially at night. And the production value of all the lighting that's going on around the festival site is very, very unique. I find it very exciting to transition into that other side of it. So once you do the whole studio thing, you take advantage of a lot of different techniques, and you know, you can layer so much more. The production is a totally different approach. But I find it to be an exciting transition point from taking that material and turning it into something that will work in a live atmosphere. And the different elements and core elements you have to change to make that work. And as that process continues, kind of what you realize, different elements that might be more important than others, you know, how to arrange amongst the four of us. We're a four piece, so, you know, how everybody's kind of conversing with each other. So I always find that an exciting step, because it's one more step of development, you know, it's a continued evolution. I mean, it's always going to be harder, but we have assembled a really, really good team of people to facilitate all of the technical aspect of it in terms of setting up and all of that. A club show is always going to be easier because you have all day to set up, and you have a, you know, 2 hour sound check, and it's a different pace. You know, the 15 minute, half an hour changeover is always going to be psychologically very hectic. But I feel like that adds almost to the nature of kind of the overall feeling, psychological feeling of festivals in general. They are hectic. It's very intense. You're coming into a place that is going to be a sensory overload for as long as you're there. There's constantly music coming from different directions. You walk 50 yards, you're hearing three bands at the same time, and then you're picking one way to go. I mean, it's overwhelming. The hardest festivals to play are always the ones that you have as little change over time as possible, because that's always going to mean the people that are working backstage are incredibly stressed out, not in a good mood, and it gives this overall environment of just really, it's really tense, and that's not really helpful for anybody, them or us or anyone. So, and if you add torrential rain to that as well, that can be a problem. But you know, sometimes some of those instances turn into a great show because you harness that, like we were talking about earlier, you harness that emotion and that energy and explode it into the live show. I would say the shows that are always so memorable in a positive way are the ones that are just incredibly surprising. The first time we ever played Poland, we had no idea what to expect, and we played this festival. We, you know, didn't know how we got booked, didn't really know what we were getting into, and got on stage in front of thousands of rabid, rabid music fans. And it was an incredibly cathartic experience. So it's always, yeah, it's those really emotional moments that take you by surprise. Last night I got to see it, because we got here a day early. So last night I saw some stuff I wanted to see. I saw Baraka San Sistema, who I was really like, Nikki and the Dove, Gas Lamp Killer. Always wanted to see Square Pusher. I'm a bass player, so I always wanted to see that guy play bass and see his custom rig. So I got to see that, talk to him for a little bit, which was really, really nice. And yeah, so saw a bunch of music. Today I was kind of recovering from seeing all that music because Square Pusher played at like 3 o'clock in the morning. I think he went on at like 3:15 or 3:30, you know. So today has been a little bit more mellow. Gonna eat some dinner, gonna mellow out, eat some food, you know. Twin Shadows playing on our stage right before us. George is there, so probably see him. So we'll see.